Hello everybody, it's Technojock on the FTG server here with another Qantas for you. And I am busy excavating a big bit of mountain here. I'll show you where I am. Reverse. Just round from the tower up through the railcraft tower thing. And I have been building out a fair bit actually. A fair bit of building out and building up here. So this is overlooking Hook's sluice gate here. So this bit of mountain's not really being used, or wasn't really being used, and it now is. So I have shifted the melons through to this area here, and it goes down all the way down to actually onto the roof of the tunnel, the rail tunnel, and then it goes all the way up there. So it's been going very, very nicely. Let's take a toddle down and see how many melons have we got. 136 stacks of melons. That's nice. And it, I think it had 96 stacks when I logged in and started moving things. So it's done a fair bit since. And I've got ways of getting up and down and all this bit here. I have made nice little stairs. It's all quite aesthetically pleasing in terms of, well, it's quite austere. But then you come up here and we're going to be... Oh, really? Oh, really? Is that how it's going to go, is it? Clearly, I have not lit this bit up properly. But that will come in time. So this bit here, you'll be wondering, okay then, you've got your melons and you've done this bit and you appear to be making other farms. Well, they're not farms. They are the layout of the floor plan of the machines I'm wanting to use from Immersive Engineering. Let's take a gander. So I want to be able to make myself some decent power now. We're into the Steel Age, we can make power, and there's now some machines that we are wanting to use power with, but I don't have really anything I can power just now. So diesel generator is what I am ultimately wanting to do. I think the system should be able to run two diesel generators. So that is what I'm going to do. That's why I've got two bits there for diesel generators, and then I will have one bit for the other stuff that I'm going to need, because I obviously need to make diesel. So we've got simple machines. No, I don't think it's in there. I think it's, well, heavy machinery. There we go. So to get diesel, in fact, let's do it this way. Let's have a look at, oh, that is not how you spell diesel. So, diesel, biodiesel, from Immersive Engineering, is made in a refinery from plant oil and ethanol. Ethanol is made in an industrial fermenter from melons. Okay, so we're good in that respect. And plant oil can be made from melon seeds, an industrial squeezer. So we need an industrial squeezer, an industrial fermenter, a refinery, and the diesel generator itself. So we've got floor pans here for, if we have a look at the squeezer, that is a 3x3 floor plan there. And I think it goes three up the way, but worry about the up way in due course. So 3x3 there. The fermenter is also 3x3, and then the refinery is a 3x5 or a 5x3, depending on which way you put it round. And the diesel generators are also 3x5. So we'll have squeezer, fermenter, refinery, and then two diesel generators like that. And then this one, I need to be able to make myself a blast furnace because I need some steel, and I don't have a source of steel presently. So that's what I'm doing here just now, and then I'm laying all of this out. And I'm thinking if this is going to be... Let's have a look and see. Each of these, so that's five along the way. Let's stop. Right, there we go. So we want to go... No, I need to... Right. Ah, there we go. That's what I wanted. So, yeah, it's three tall for the refinery. The squeezer. Is also... Yeah, three tall. I would imagine the fermenter and everything are all going to be three tall. So what I need to do is, this is only a three tall bit, and I'm going to want to have probably another layer, two layers above that. So if I make it, if I just go up like, where am I going to go? Here. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I want to use my Omnimine. Right. If I go up, three, and then I can put in a layer for the roof like that, so there will be enough space on top of these machines for me to stand if need be, but that's mostly going to be piping and stuff. Maybe I want to make it go one more, maybe one more like that, yeah, and then we can come out like so. Like that. There we go. And then we can go and go round the way. That's going to be fine as well. Let's go here. Like that. Altogether sure how this is going to look like this. Certainly this is going to go right. Let's grab it here and come out like that. This is going to be a bit fiddly to do, I think. And this is not the best method of building like this. But we will come out. It's easier than climbing, but not as easy as if I had creative flight. Right, that's what I'm wanting, like that. And then we're going to come along like that. And one more, like that. There we go. And then we can come over like so. And then what's going to happen? What's going to happen is I'm going to fall off. But what I can do is, like this, smash that window, and that window. And then come along like that. Yep. Need to come in here, I think, probably. To go like that. Might need to go up a level, actually. I'll just use the stairs. Get a bit of exercise. Yeah. Ah. Need to take that one out as well. There we go. Like that. Now it might be better to take it up one more again, and that way it would link in with that floor. That might be more aesthetically pleasing from the inside. I don't know if you can notice it from the outside, but let's have a look and see. Yeah, you kinda can. You kinda can. Okay. Yep. Well, that's what we'll do then. It's not the end of the world. Do and do like that, and do and do and do, and then like so, and then we'll need to come along, but we'll need to take out all of this, and we'll need to do another layer here. So let me clear this area out and put this area all sorted out with that, and I will put in the windows as well, because I'll need to come along here and put in windows like this. These are the chiseled transparent blocks that I've done, and I've got a pattern on me, so I'll be using a pattern for the most part for that, and I shall see you once it gets light and I've sorted that out. So I've got all of this sorted out. It's all nicely enclosed now, apart from this bit which I'm using to get to and from. And as you can see, I've already got one of the machines up and going. I've got this crude blast furnace. And the reason that I did that is because I need it to make steel for all of the rest of the stuff, and I wanted to get a little bit of a head start. Now, I'm not sticking with the crude blast furnace because it is crude. I'm wanting to get the improved blast furnace, so I have the bits I need for that just now. One thing I will tell you though is be very careful when you're playing around with this thing and you've got it full up of stuff and it's just about to make your block of steel, to not accidentally shoot it with a break block thing or something like that and break one of the blocks, because it makes the multi-block unform, and then you lose all of the stuff that's in there and all of the progress that you've made with it, which is a little bit annoying, to say the least. Not that we've got a lack of iron, but the progress for the steel was annoying to have lost. So I've got the 27 blocks there, and as you can see, I'm using factory blocks here from Chisel. They're really nice. Quite like the look of these. So I want to make another 27 steel plates like this. There we go. I'm going to need to make myself a new engineer's hammer very shortly, I think. So that gives us these reinforced blast bricks like that. And now, if we have a look at this, we guess make the 3x3 again, and then we need to put a hopper on the top. As you can see, there we go. So let's make the 3x3 again. And I think I've got the hopper in here. I do. Good. And like this. Now the hopper is going to go there. We'll hop down. Hop down. There we go. And then if I use the engineer's hammer, whack it on the front. There we go. That's it. Done. Very, very cool indeed. Love this thing. It looks so good. Right, now I can put charcoal in the bottom there, and I'll grab some iron. So let's grab a stack of... I didn't really mean to do that. Let's grab a stack of iron, put it in like that. There we go. What I am going to do is... recipe that, do like... recipe of that. Do like that. Cool. That's it all back like that. Cool. So that's going to start making us some more stuff. Now the benefit of the improved blast furnace is that you can pipe the stuff in and out of it. All very good. Now, things I want to do. I want to get one of these drawers. I've made some cool framed drawers like that. That looks very cool. Quite happy with that. Although I might change round the way it's facing, but I'm not too bothered about that at the moment. And I'm going to put that underneath like that. Cool. Yep. I might Ah, now that's outputting the steel. I don't want it to output the steel. I want it to output the slag that's in there. So let's see if we can get the slag to come out. Maybe if we have something like another hopper. Maybe another hopper. Let's get five iron. Five iron. And do I have some more wood on me? I've got plenty of wood on me. Right. Let's make ourselves a chest. Like a so. Don't think I have to make it into a normal chest like that. Let's get the hopper. And let's see if... let's see if putting the framed drawer there and like that. Does that take that out? It does not take that out. How am I going to get that stuff out? Not altogether sure. I would quite like it to come out like that though. Okay, I'll need to look into that. But we've got other stuff to do as well. I have got far too much stuff on me for it to be healthy. And that's interesting. But what I want to do is get that, that, and those. So I have got iron sheet metal, which is four plates that you can make just by hammering an iron ingot, and that gets you four of these. And then I'm going to take this and that. I need to make two of those coils. And I don't have enough iron on me. That was unfortunate. Let's grab you like that. Right. So, where was I? That with that and that, and that gives us two external heaters. All good. Those can be used for a number of things, but what we're using them for here is making these iron, these preheater things. Why didn't that go on in the right way? Do I have to face it that way? No? Okay, maybe I've got to actually go from that side. Yeah, there we go. That makes it stick on properly. These things look so cool. And basically, what I need to do is I need to provide this with some power, and that will make it heat up more and quicker and whatnot. So it will process quicker, which is excellent. We want exactly that, but we are a little ways away from being able to do that. What I do want to do is have... I want to have coal going in. I want coal going in, iron going in as well, and stuff. Right, I'm going to worry about that in a little bit, because that does look cool. If I can get that to have the slag going into that, steel going into something nearby, and I'm going to have that. Cool. But, yeah, worry about that in a moment. What I'm going to do now, though, is... here's some stuff I prepared earlier. We've got all the bits that we need for building our squeezer thing for the seeds. So let's have a look at that. Simple machines. Yeah, simple machines, isn't it? Or is it heavy machine? Heavy machine. Squeezer. Here we go. Here we go. So, we need all these bits. So we need to make got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of the scaffold and then a light engineering block. Can get rid of that. So this is going to come like that, and a light engineering block there, and then the scaffold like this. Yeah, cool. Then we've got the redstone block and the other. So redstone block there, that there. Then we've got piston facing down the way, and we've got those four things. So I've got them on me. So that's those. I need the piston to be facing down the way, and I need these four things like that. These will go around like that. I could probably do with getting in here a bit easier. Like that, and that way. Yeah, perfect. Like that, then that, and that. Cool beans. And I think, is that not it? Is that not it? It looks like it. Formed by using the engineer's hammer on the central wooden barrel. There we go. Cool. Nice one. Oh, that looks really cool. I like that. So, we'll need to put a lever on there to turn it on. Should have levers, although I think I may have put them away. But I have wood and I have cobblestone, so yeah. What did I do with all my wood? There it is. Like that, and like that. Let's make a few. That'll be cool. So that's nice. Let's get 8 of you. Like that. This can go here along the bottom. And like that. That's cool. That is done. Nice one. And then that's going to pipe out into and over to that. Maybe I should have actually put it facing this way. Maybe I should have. Right, we'll see about that. I might change it round. Next up we've got this thing, which is going to be largely the same, I think. This is going to be the fermenter. Yeah, I think it looks exactly the same. So I'm going to make it face this way. And like that. And then like get rid of that. Then we've got the light engineering blocks here and here. Let's get rid of this because we're going to have four cauldrons. If I can just kind of stay in the one place, that'd be great. I don't need a piston for this one, do I? So I can just place this stuff on the top. Yeah, there's no piston or anything on the top of this one. So that's fine. That goes like that. These go there and there like that. In a weird way. And then the sheet metal. And, oh, missing the redstone thingy bob there. There we go. Excellent. So yeah, that one faces this way. I think I will change this one round, but we'll put the lever on there like that. Cool beans. Nice one. Really liking how these are going to be looking. And that's going to be good. We're doing okay here. Let's put some more in there. And we are pretty good to go. Now, what we do have the issue of here is I don't have any power to power these to make power. These are going to be making our power for us. That's all, you know, this is going to be squeezing stuff. This is going to be fermenting stuff. And it's all going to be going, made into biodiesel and go into two big generators. And it's going to get us lots of power. But we need power before we can do that, which is a little bit inconvenient at this point. So I have a plan for that. So let me get it all set up and get some more steel on the go. So we're going to be ready to kickstart this in just a minute. Right, I think we're just about ready. I have opened up another area through the back here, and I have made one of these thermoelectric generators from Immersive Engineering. These things are... They're not the simplest things to make. They're kind of definitely mid-tier. They need this Constantin plate, which is made from Constantin ingots, which I accidentally made a good while ago in the smeltery. I can't remember how it is exactly it is made. Where are you? You're not going to tell me, are you? Alloying, there we go. Copper and nickel. So cupronickel is Constantan. So yeah, I made that by accident a long time ago, so I'm quite glad that I've got something to do with this stuff. So by taking this Constantan, making it like that, and then with some steel across the top, we get one of these thermoelectric generators, which is rather nice. Now, I want to put that up at the top there. And where's my hammer? What have I done with it now? What have I done with it this time? My inventory is horrendous. Okay, it doesn't actually allow me to do... to change that. So let's hope that this works as I think it might, because I'm going to put this one in on top of there. Right. Now I get my bucket and I'm going to go and put one lava there and a water there. And that should be outputting. Is it? Is it? No, it is not. Right. Only outputs to the bottom. That's not a huge issue. It's not the world's worst thing to have happened, because I have another LV capacitor. That's the word I was looking for. There you go. And that's going to start charging up. Those capacitors are pretty easy to make. Those ones are there. So treated wood planks, copper, lead, iron, and redstone gets you one of these. And it stores 100,000 RF, or IF as it's referred to, for immersive flux. But that's fine. Now I do need another one. I'm going to grab this and go put that there. So this one will charge up as well in just a moment. There we go. It's starting to charge up. That one's charging up, but I will need a third one, because the RF output of these things is 15 per like heat gradient. So that lava and that water are causing a heat gradient across the thermoelectric generator, which gives us about 15 RF per tick. And the same for that lava and that water there. So in total, 30 RF per tick. Now these take a little bit more than 30 RF. It's 16 each, I think it is. So obviously 32 for the both of them. So I want that to be powered nicely. It is actually producing a fair bit of steel as it is, but I want to beef that up a little bit. So I'm going to have to sort that out in a second, but it'll be okay for the moment. Actually, no, I'm going to make the one more and do that in just a second. Let me just quickly open up the roof of this one and faff around and get this sorted out, and then we'll be ready to connect this up in just a second. got this all connected up in here. We've got three thermoelectric generators connected to three different capacitors passing through this LV wire relay, because you can only connect one wire to an LV wire connector. So LV wire connectors on that side, LV wire relay here, puts them all together, goes over into this LV capacitor here. So we've got a decent amount of power storage at this end. And then if I connect that to there, and then I need to jump up here, connect it up to there. So that should be coming through. Is that, I haven't set this side to be an output, have I? And that's it. You can just see the orange bit there. Blue's in, orange is out, so that is charged up there. And then if I come over here and go that to there, that to there, that should be those powered. And if I get some iron from here, let's just get like that. Got a stack of iron just about, and that should be it now. Oh yeah, that's going a lot faster now. That's pretty much on a par with a normal furnace, really, isn't it? Smelting iron ore. That looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. So I reread the book as well, and it tells me that I need to have my input and output things. The input for coal and for iron goes in through the top. My input, my output for slag comes out here, so that's where I've got that, and my output for steel comes out through the front, which I haven't set up as yet. In fact, let's do that now. Shall I put it like that? That's coming out fine. I'll need another one of those. That should be okay. So we've got steel coming out there. Still need to set up the input, but I'm going to do something different with that. But let's quickly have a look at this. I have got melon seeds in here and melons in here. And if I come over here, I should be able to go connect there and come over to here and connect to there, then connect down to there and connect down to there. This is already doing stuff because I saw it moving. Yep, there's a plunger thing plunging. This is doing. Yep, it is doing stuff and things. This is also doing at pretty much the same speed as that. That's excellent. And I presume this is just a cutoff. So if I do that, it'll stop. Yeah, it's powering up. Let's turn this one off as well, because I'm not sure. I don't think that this, well, I know that this doesn't keep up with that. That should be, yeah, it's fully charged. If I turn these on, we'll see that this power will probably go down. Well, we put this power here. Yeah, that's gone. That's going pretty quickly. And that one's already gone as well. And yeah, the power is gone in this. So it doesn't have enough power to keep up with this at the moment. So we'll turn that off. But we've got a little bit of plant oil there and a little bit of ethanol there. Yeah. So those keep nice and steady. This is going well. That's keeping up nicely with that. I've got the charcoal in the hopper at the top there. I'm going to want to do something different with that. Let's see about getting this fermenter up and going, shall we? Or in fact, how are we doing for time, people? How are we doing for time? Right, let's get rid of a bunch of stuff from us at the moment anyway. I want to get an output node, a master routing node, and an input node. That is going to go, yeah. Gonna take this, gonna take that, around that. I'm going to put that there. I need two input nodes. So output, that's an input. So input from there, input from there. Actually looks pretty good. Output will go up. Up there. Yep, that'll work. I want to filter that though. I'm going to put the master node there. Where is... I think it's up at the base. So let's go up here. I think I put it in this chest. But no, I did not. But I definitely need one of these. At least. I'll take both, just in case. Where is my node doohickey thing? There it is. There it is. Have myself something to eat. And let's head on down. Ooh. Oh, I can't actually work my broom. Such is my excitement of getting this stuff sorted out. Very excited about getting this stuff sorted out. I think it's going to be great. So, I'm wanting one piece of charcoal. I'll need to get my iron into there. Fill this all up with iron. Lots and lots of iron. Lovely. Pick it up. Thank you. And we'll take that as well. So, let's head on up here. Let's go and have a look at this. Output node. It'll be the downside. Can I... Right, what's going on? What is going on? Right. Downside. I want... let's say I want 64. So we'll keep a stack of charcoal in there. And we want... also a stack of iron ingots kept in there. In fact, no. I only want five. Five iron ingots and charcoal, five as well. There we go. Now, do that, and that, that, and that, that, and that. Now, what's going on up here now? Yep, it's keeping the five charcoal and five iron. Oh, no, that's not really... Oh, yeah, that's... Yeah, that's working. That is working. It's keeping everything topped up as I wanted it to. Just a small buffer there, so it'll fill up as quickly as possible. Nice! The only other thing I need to do is to put a void upgrade on this, because I'm not going to really want that much slag, I don't think. But yeah, that's it. I'm going to leave these machines for the next episode, which I shall be recording almost straight away. But I'm afraid you're going to have to wait to see what happens next time on... Qantas here on the FTG server. Thanks very much, folks. I've had a great time. I hope you've had a great time too. If you have, leave a like and leave a message for me as well if you've got any suggestions, questions, tips, tricks, all the rest of it. And I shall see you the next time, guys. Bye-bye.